in journalism led you to winning some top award? You won the award as a top journalist?
Well, alhamdulillah, you know, it takes a lot of passion, a lot of hard work, and let's be honest about it. Awards are not the end all in one's career. It does spur you on to go to the next level. It does spur you on and motivate you. And alhamdulillah, over the years, I won a number of awards, named the Journalist of the Year for at least three consecutive years by the then Pretoria Press Club. I won a number of security awards. I even, about six years ago, received the highest order from the South African government, namely a national order by the order of Baobab in silver for community service. And alhamdulillah, over the years, I continued my career from a young reporter at 702, became a full-time reporter, became the crime editor. Crime is a big issue in South Africa. Mm-hmm. Then became the news editor, became the editor, became the station manager of the radio station, eventually became the group head of news and current affairs for the four radio stations within the stable. And then about 5 or 6 years ago, I decided to call it quits with the corporate world. I then actively became involved in the fight against crime. I'm currently the vice president of Crime Stoppers International, which is a global body very active in the United States and other parts of the world, even in the Caribbean, for that matter.
What's the name of that crime organization?
It's called Crime Stoppers International.
I didn't get the second word. Crime?
Crime Stoppers, like Stop Crime Stoppers.
Right, International. Crime Stoppers International.
Very
good.
Active, very, very popular in especially the Caribbean. And by the way, I've been to the Caribbean, to many parts of that particular part of the world for conferences and meetings. The communities are very actively involved. So we are a charity or a non-profit organization, and we encourage communities to blow the whistle on crime. I'm also very actively involved in the fight against the illicit trade. So the illicit trade is massive across the world, but in South Africa, especially the cigarette trade is a big problem. I founded a non-profit organization called Tax Justice South Africa. And alhamdulillah, we're trying to make a difference in our community. And also over the years, thanks to people like Kari Ziad Patel from the Al Dindar Foundation, we've been very actively involved in humanitarian work. I accompanied him a few years ago to Syria and to Turkey, mm-hmm, where we took mm-hmm. millions and millions of rands of much needed aid to people in the refugee camps after the Aleppo attack. So alhamdulillah, wherever we can, we try to make a difference in our community and see how we can really help the people in need, not only in South Africa, but across.